PCOS, or polycystic ovary syndrome, is a very common problem in women of reproductive age. It is the single most common cause of ovulation problems. There are different types. How do you know if you have PCOS? If you're trying to have a baby, does it matter what type of PCOS you have? With the help of a recent study, I'm going to answer these questions for you. Stay tuned. In medicine, a disease is a problem with a specific cause and resulting in a specific presentation, whereas a syndrome is a collection of several different signs and symptoms. Not all people with a syndrome will have the same signs and symptoms. PCOS is a syndrome. For example, some people with PCOS may have high testosterone levels while others may not. This makes diagnosing someone with PCOS more complicated. To make matters even more confusing, there are three different organizations that have produced three different criteria for making the diagnosis of PCOS. This means that you could meet the criteria for having PCOS in one classification system, but not in another. Recently, doctors conducted two multicenter studies known as the Pregnancy and Polycystic Ovary Syndrome, or PPCOS 1 and 2. In total, over 1,300 people with PCOS were studied, making this one of the largest studies of its kind ever conducted. In the study I'm going to discuss today, they divided women with PCOS into two groups. The first group are those who had evidence for high levels of a group of hormones known as androgens. Some of these women had blood tests like testosterone, which were elevated. The remainder of this group had symptoms of high androgens, such as acne or unwanted hair growth. Of course, some women had both. This high androgen group were compared to other women with PCOS who did not have evidence for high androgens. Okay, so what did we learn? Women with PCOS in the high androgen group tended to weigh more. They had a higher BMI. At the time of the study, they had been trying to become pregnant for a longer period of time. When they tried fertility treatments, they were less successful. The proportion of patients who achieved pregnancy was 30% in the high androgen group versus 40% in the normal androgen group. As a result, the chance for having a live birth was lower, 20% versus 33%. The researchers performed an analysis to show that this difference in pregnancy rates could not be attributed to the higher weight in the high androgen group. Both groups had about the same miscarriage risk. It is known that people with PCOS have a higher rate of pregnancy complications such as gestational diabetes, preeclampsia, premature delivery, and poor fetal growth. Because of small numbers, the researchers were not able to determine whether the high androgen group had a higher rate of pregnancy complications compared to the normal androgen group. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: PCOS is a common problem, and there is no universally agreed upon method to diagnose it. If you see a fertility specialist, it is important to determine whether you have high androgens, because this group is less likely to successfully conceive. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.